We went with what we'd read in magazines as far as recommended fertilizer rates, which was basically don't fertilize it and you can grow it, it'll be fine. Well, yeah, you can grow it and it'll be okay, but you're not going to get good yield and you're really going to see some major variations in the field. We're getting better at it, but there's not a lot of data out there that's available to know what I should fertilize rye at. There's good numbers for oats and those numbers are changing. And there's some good resources for oats, but for things like rye, there's not a lot of resources as far as fertilizer goes still. NDSU has some decent numbers, but that's for their soil types, and I don't know how, if their recommendations will transfer down here perfectly, but that's what we're using right now for our fertilizer rates.
Well, I've kind of done limited fertilizer. I've tried some nitrogen on it in the spring. I've had good luck getting a lot of biomass and got a lot of growth. As far as yield, I've had mixed results with nitrogen and yield. Now this last year, I took a little different approach. We did some leaf test, sent in some leaf tissue samples just to kind of see what we were lacking. And one of the things I found by doing that is that we were short in boron and sulfur, some of the micronutrients. So I kind of focused more on putting that in the fertilizer. I put 30 pounds of nitrogen on, but we added boron and sulfur to it. And I had good results this year. I don't know if it was because it was just a good year for the rye. I'm going to plan on doing it next year again just to see if it follows through another year. But where we did it, we did a side-by-side yield check, and it made 10 bushel to the acre difference on most of it. Some of it was up 15 to 20 bushel, just depending on the soil type you were on. But I had good results doing that, and that's the best response I've gotten out of any fertilizer on rye.
With rye, I'd like to get dry fertilizer put on before the crop. It's a challenge since we're not doing the fertilizing ourselves. We're hiring a local company to do it. We have to work on their schedule. So we'd put dry fertilizer down, then I'll drill. And then early spring, way early spring, like just after frost thaws out, we'll go in and put on AMS, a decent amount of AMS for nitrogen fertilizer and sulfur.
So whether you're talking about a winter grain or you're talking about a spring grain, right? N, P, and K are obviously essential nutrients, and they're going to determine yield potential, and they're going to do it fairly early on. So again, whether you're managing an organic or a conventional system, you need to make sure to have an adequate supply of N, P, and K for these cereals, right? And it's not quite what we're talking about with corn and beans, all right? So instead of, let's say, a pound removal, which is what's commonly recommended for corn, if we want to go by that metric, with oats, for instance, or wheat, we're talking more like 3/4 of a pound or 8/10 of a pound, all right? And if you're managing in a system where you can use synthetic nitrogen, this period here, this Z3, when you're tillering and jointing in between this stage, when you add supplemental nitrogen at this point, you greatly enhance the plant's ability to put on additional tillers, which does potentially increase your yield ceiling by increasing the number of possible seed heads you can have in a given surface area. One thing that I would be wary of recommending is that over-N additions can be just as detrimental sometimes as not having enough N. So we have, especially in a crop like oats that's a little taller, or rye or triticale, these crops that are taller and that haven't been bred necessarily for high-N conditions, when you add too much N, you can have an issue like lodging, which is you end up promoting a ton of growth and you get these very lush stems and you get these heavy seed heads. And then what you have is, on a windy day or, you know, on a heavy rain or if soil conditions are right, the plants can fall over, which makes management a real hassle and can greatly reduce your yield potential.